Hello students, welcome to the next online lecture. From this lecture onwards, we will be studying the next type of RCC structure, which is RCC water tanks or liquid retaining structures. So, water tanks or liquid retaining structures are the structures which are used to store water or any other type of liquid in large quantities. The water tanks or liquid retaining structures can be of different materials like concrete, stone, brick, RCC, steel or polyethylene, etc. So the water tanks can be of different capacities according to the water demand and the water usage of that particular area. For example, in our houses of one or two family dwellings, we generally prefer concrete tanks or brick tanks or the precast ready-made polyethylene tanks, which are most commonly used nowadays. For colonies having large number of flats or family dwellings, we require large capacities of water to be stored. And for industrial buildings, factories and godowns, etc., we may require water or other chemicals to be stored in large amount. So for that we require RCC water tanks. So these are the different types of RCC water tanks which can be used for storing water or any other type of liquid. These are the pictures I have collected from internet. These are the water tanks, overhead water tanks located above the ground level, and these are the water tanks resting on ground and underground tanks which will be covered with earth fill. Now every RCC structure, the design of every RCC structure requires a set of codes and specifications which need to be followed, and that is available in the form of IS codes. So for the design of RCC water tanks, we require these four codes: IS 3370 part 1 to part 4. So these are the code of practice, IS code of practice for concrete structures for storage of liquids. Part 1 is for general requirements, part 2 is for RCC structures only, part 3 is for pre-stressed concrete structures only, so we do not require in this particular topic, and last is the design tables for the design of the water tanks. So we will be using these codes, these three codes, part 1, 2 and part 4 in the coming slides. So any RCC structure, before designing, we need to choose the design philosophy or design methodology which we will adopt for its design. In the previous course and in all the previous RCC structures, we chose limit state method as the method of design, as the design philosophy, because of its various advantages. But for the design of RCC water tanks, we use working stress method. As I have explained to you earlier in the previous course also, that working stress method has many disadvantages, but it has some prominent advantages. That is, the structures made of working stress method are very strong and are leak proof or crack free, because there is no warning of crack, and cracking is not at all allowed in working stress method. So for water tank or any liquid storage, we require a structure which should be strong, durable and most importantly leak proof, because if the water, there are cracks in the water tank, the liquid can leak through it, which is not at all desirable for our requirement. Therefore working stress method is preferable because it does not allow the formation of cracks and is safer for the liquid retaining structures. So working stress method is based on the theory that the forces acting on the element, any RCC or any other type of structural element, should be less than the stresses which are allowable in that particular element for different types of forces. Like the tension force should be less than the allowable tensile stresses, the bending stresses must be less than the allowable bending stresses, etc. So I'll be explaining you the working stress method which we require in this particular topic. So I'll be explaining it in brief. The For the design from working stress method, we require these design constants, which are M, K, J and R. M is the modular ratio, 280 upon 3 sigma CBC, where sigma C is the permissible bending stresses in concrete. And this value we get from table number 2 of IS 3370 part 2 code. So as I have explained to you in the previous slides, we require these codes for the design. So IS 3370 part 2 gives the various permissible stresses, bending stresses, tensile stresses, compressive stresses, etc. for concrete as well as steel according to the grade of concrete and steel. I'll be showing you this in the next slide. K is the neutral axis depth factor, which is M sigma CBC upon M sigma CBC plus sigma ST. M is the modular ratio, sigma CBC is the same. Sigma ST is the permissible stresses in steel, which we get from table number 4 of IS 3370 part 2. So part 2 is quite necessary for the design. Next is the lever arm depth factor, which is 1 minus K by 3. K is the neutral axis depth factor. And last is the moment of resistance factor, R, which is half sigma CBC into J into K. So we require all these four parameters, and we will use these design constants or design parameters for calculating the bending moment and the area of reinforcement in the any type of RCC structure. So these are the tables of IS 3370 part 2 given on page number 2 and 3. Table number 1 is for sigma CT, which is the design permissible concrete stresses in tension and tension due to bending. So generally we require this value. So for different grades of concrete, you can see different values of sigma CT, which is direct tension stresses. Next is the permissible stresses in concrete, bending stresses, direct stresses and bond stresses. So we require sigma CBC here, as we require sigma CBC for the calculation of M and K and R. So sigma CBC is this for different types of grades. So sigma CBC basically means like that for M35 concrete, at any section of your element, the bending stresses should not be more than 11.5 Newton per mm squared. Similarly for other types of stresses also. And this is table number 2. And table number 4 is for permissible stresses in steel, for tensile stresses and compressive stresses. For tension steel we will be using this value, for compression steel we will be using this value. So you require these three tables for the determination of the design constants M, K, J and R. So why do we calculate these M, K, J and R? As you all know that for calculations for design, we require the dimensions or thickness or depth of a particular section and the reinforcement in that particular section. So depth required is summation M upon RB, where R is the design parameter as calculated here, half sigma CBC J into K. If you remember limit state method, in limit state method also we use the same formula, D is equal to under root M upon RB. Here R is the also a constant which depends on the grade of concrete and the grade of steel. For example, it was 0.138 FCK for some cases and so on. So but the expression is same, but the value of R is different here. Now second thing we require is the reinforcement required. So in limit state method we use the formula M is equal to 0.87 M is equal to 0.87 F by AST D 1 minus AST upon BD F by upon FCK. This is for limit state method, but for working stress method the reinforcement required due to moment will be M upon sigma STJD. Here we calculated reinforcement by solving this equation, quadratic equation. Now in working stress method directly you can use this formula, where sigma ST is the permissible stresses in steel, J is the design constant and D is the effective thickness. If the reinforcement is to be provided to carry a tensile force or a compressive force, then AST will be T upon sigma ST, where T is the tensile force, and C upon sigma ST if it is a compressive force. So these three formulas we will be using to find out the reinforcement and the dimension of the tank components. Some of the important IS code recommendations for water tanks are: the minimum reinforcement required is 0.35% of cross section of surface zone for high yield strength deformed bars and 0.6564% for mild steel bars. Surface zone here means normally the thickness or the depth of total component, like this is the surface zone for a particular section of wall of tank, but in some cases half thickness is considered. We will be discussing it when the case comes. Normally minimum 200 mm thickness is provided for a particular tank wall or tank slab. Spacing of reinforcement is should not be greater than lesser of 300 mm or thickness of the section. Minimum grade of concrete is M30. The cover provided in the tank wall or base slab of the tank is normally higher as for beams and columns, because these are exposed to water directly, and if tank is resting on ground and it is the base slab, then the base slab is resting on soil, so the exposure condition is severe. So the cover required will be more in case of base slab and slightly less in case of the tank wall. Now this is the detailed classification of RCC water tank. RCC water tank can be of three types depending on their location. That is, they can be resting on ground, they can be underground, or they can be elevated or overhead. Each type can be of different shape, like tank resting on ground can be circular or rectangular. Underground tank can also be circular or rectangular, and similarly overhead tank. Further, the circular tanks can be of two types, with flexible base and with rigid base, in case of tanks resting on ground and underground tanks also. We will be discussing these cases in this particular presentation. Rectangular tanks can be of two types depending on the ratio of length to width of the rectangle tank. If length to width ratio is less than 2, then the design will be slightly different than if it is greater than 2. Now similarly for underground tanks. Last is the elevated tanks. Elevated tanks, which are circular tanks commonly, can have domed top and flat bottom, domed top and spherical domed bottom, and domed top and conical domed bottom. You must have seen these types of tanks very commonly. I will be showing you in detail in the coming slides. Now I have collected some pictures from the internet to show you the different types of tanks, pictures of different types of tanks. First is the circular classification, is the circular tanks resting on ground. So these are different types of circular tanks resting on ground. It can be used to store different types of liquids. Next is rectangular tanks resting on ground. These are the rectangular tanks resting on ground, as you can see here. Next is the circular underground tanks. Mostly the tanks are made underground, as it saves the space. So these are the different types of circular underground tanks. Next is the rectangular underground tanks. These are some of the rectangular underground tanks which are buried below the ground surface. Next are the circular overhead or elevated water. These are used for large storage tanks. You must have seen these types of tanks around you very commonly. This is a circular tank, this is inch tank, spherical bottom tank, domed bottom tank, conical bottom tank. They can be of different shapes. Here the tank is having flat bottom. This is also flat bottom, this is also flat bottom. Here the bottom is slightly conical at the bottom. So all these tanks are of different shapes. And last is the rectangular overhead tanks. Rectangular overhead tanks are normally less frequently used as compared to the circular overhead tanks, but these are some of the pictures which I got from internet. Now before we will be starting with the design of these different types of tanks one by one. So each type of RCC water tank can be analyzed and designed with any of the two methods. Each type of tank has two methods of analysis which we will study. First is the approximate method and next is the direct IS code method. So for some of the questions I will be explaining you through approximate method and some of the IS code method. I will be showing you how it is, both are different. Basically approximate method, as the name is suggesting, here we are using some approximations and assumptions for calculations of forces and moments. And in the IS code method we are using directly IS code tables of IS 3370 part 4 for the calculation of forces and moments. So we will be studying both these types. So let's first start with tanks resting on ground. Tanks resting on ground is important because the design of walls of tanks, the design of tank walls, if this is a rectangular tank, if it is present on the ground or below the ground or above the ground, there can be three cases. In all these three cases, if these are the walls of the tank, the design of walls will be same in all these cases, almost same, not exactly same, but 99% it will be same. So tanks resting on ground is basically, we are designing here the tank walls. So the design of walls for tanks resting on ground will be followed for the other two cases also. So tanks resting on ground can be of two types, circular tanks and rectangular tanks. Circular tanks can be with flexible base or with rigid or fixed base. So in this particular presentation we will be studying this part only, that is circular tanks with flexible base and circular tanks with rigid base which are resting on ground. So circular tank, parts of a circular tank are these two. If this is a tank, circular tank, these are the cylindrical walls and this is the base slab or the base of your tank wall, and this is located at the ground level, at the ground surface. Normally the top of the tank is covered with a lid or any type of covering. Design of this top part is not required, as negligible loads are acting on this particular portion. So the design part requires the design of tank wall and the base slab of your tank. Now if you see here, this is a circular tank on ground. The connection of your tank wall with the base slab determines whether it can be designed in which way. The first case is if this connection is flexible, that is the connection of tank wall with base slab is flexible, and the second case is if this is a tank wall and this is base slab. If this connection is flexible, then the design will be slightly different, and if this is fixed, the design will be different. So first we will be taking up the case of circular tanks with flexible base, and I will be explaining this with the help of approximate method first. Now circular tank with flexible base. So see this diagram. This is a water tank. This tank is filled with water here inside. So the main force which will be acting on the tank wall will be the water pressure from this from the water inside the tank. So in this first case the joint is flexible. What does the flexible joint means? If this is the base and this is the wall. Then flexible joint means some little movement, either rotation or displacement, is allowed in this particular part. So if this part is flexible, then there will be no displacements or rotations, hence there will be no resisting moments or resisting forces, hence movement at this point will be zero. I hope you understand this concept from structural analysis. So this is the major difference between the rigid base and flexible face tank. Now what is the load subjected to this tank? If this is the plan of your tank, this is a circular tank, the water pressure is the hydrostatic pressure on walls is the load acting on this particular tank wall, which is given by gamma into H, where H is the height of your tank wall and gamma is the gamma W, which is the density of water or any other liquid which is stored in this particular tank. Now what will happen due to this pressure, water pressure, which will be maximum at the bottom? From fluid mechanics you know that the maximum water is pressure is maximum at the bottom and it keeps on increasing with the depth. So this will be a lateral water pressure diagram, which is quite similar to that of lateral earth pressure diagram in the which we studied in the retaining wall. Now if this is your tank wall and this is the lateral force due to lateral pressure due to water, and this height is H, so what will be this pressure? The maximum pressure at the bottom will be gamma into H here. Now due to this water pressure acting on this tank wall, tension will develop on wall. As this water pressure will try to put pressure in this direction, due to this water pressure the wall of your tank has tensile force, or the walls are subjected to direct tension or hoop tension. Hoop tension, we use the word hoop tension here because this is circular, so we use hoop tension. So the formula for this tension will be the pressure acting on these, on the maximum water pressure into D by 2, where D is the diameter of your tank. It is taken by 2 because it will be distributed equally on both the sides. So T is equal to P by 2 and the maximum tension will be gamma H into D by 2. So this is the formula for direct tension, and this will be the major force, or the force which will be acting on the walls. As I have explained to you, there will be no movements developed at the base of the stem as this is flexible, so there will be no movement, hence only the direct tension or hoop tension T will be the primary force in this particular tank. So obviously the thickness required for this tank and the reinforcement in this tank will also depend on T. So the reinforcement due to this hoop tension, we have to calculate for the calculation of reinforcement due to this hoop tension, we use the formula for working stress method. AST is equal to T upon sigma ST. T is gamma H into D by 2 sigma ST. So this is the expression for AST. And what is this AST basically? If this is the tank wall, due to this tension or due to this pressure, reinforcement is provided in the form of hoops like this. So this is the reinforcement due to the hoop tension, and it is provided in the form of hoops and rings placed at a suitable spacing along the height of the wall. As you can see in this particular picture, this the circumferential reinforcement which you can see here are the hoop rings or hoop tension which are provided, which are calculated like this. AST is T upon sigma ST. So what we do, we after calculation of AST, we assume the diameter of these bars and calculate this spacing of the baths and provide these in whole of your tank. And of course, as you know, that as we go down below, the pressure keeps on increasing. So as the P will increase, the T will also increase and AST will also increase. As we move upwards, the pressure will decrease and T will also increase and reinforcement required will also decrease. So you can increase the spacing here so that less reinforcement is required in the top, and you can decrease the spacing, or you can provide closely spaced hoops here because here reinforcement is required more due to more amount of force. So thickness, now this is the reinforcement due to hope tension. Therefore, the main reinforcement in circular tanks resting on ground with the flexible base is the hoop reinforcement provided along the height of your tank in circumferential direction. Now next is the thickness of tank wall. Once we have calculated the reinforcement, we will calculate the thickness of tank wall. As there is no moment acting in this wall, so we cannot use the formula D is equal to under root M upon RB. So we will calculate thickness from this requirement. We know from working stress method that the tensile stress acting in the wall at any point, that is the tensile stress acting due to the force, that is T, should be less than the allowed or permissible tensile stresses in concrete. So this value we will get from the code IS 3370 part 2. If we know the grade of concrete, we can calculate the permissible tensile stresses from table number 1 of IS 3370. I have already showed you this table. So the direct tensile stresses, that is sigma T, which are acting, should be less than the allowable stresses. So what is sigma T? This is T upon the equivalent area of the concrete. Here we are using equivalent area because in RCC circular wall, the wall will have concrete as well as reinforcement. But we are calculating here only the permissible stresses in concrete. So the equivalent area of concrete in this wall we have to calculate. So as we know, the stress is equal to force upon area. It will be T upon equivalent area, and equivalent area will be A plus M minus 1 into AST provided. Here M minus 1 AST provided is for the calculation of the concrete area. Now A here is the cross section of your tank. So what is the cross section area of the tank? The thickness is T and the width is B. Width is generally taken as 1 meter, so T will be the A will be area of cross section of your wall will be 1000 into T plus M minus 1 AST provided. Here we will use AST provided, which we will calculate from the spacing which we have provided of the hoops. So we will get this relation. Here T is unknown, small t, this is the thickness of wall, is unknown to us. T is the direct tension force or hoop tension, which we get from gamma h d by 2. M is the modular ratio. AST provided is the area provided of the hoops. That is why we have calculated the reinforcement earlier, because we require the AST provided, and it should be less than sigma ct. This value we get from the IS 3370 part 2. From this relation, thickness of wall is calculated. So we have got the reinforcement in the wall and the thickness of the wall. Now another thing is left. Of course, we cannot have a wall only with hoop tensions. Like, imagine a circular tank wall without the vertical reinforcement. Although vertical reinforcement is not required from the point of view of analysis theoretically, but as you know, for keeping these hoops in place and for safety, we require minimum reinforcement in the other direction also. So minimum reinforcement is provided in the vertical direction. Design of base slab is not done. Calculation of reinforcement is not done, because the main forces will be taken up by the tank walls. So the design of base slab is done for minimum thickness and minimum steel. Minimum thickness of base slab is taken as 150 mm, and minimum steel is 0.35% of cross section in each direction. that is the slab provided below this circular tank. If I will show you here, if this is the slab provided, either circular or rectangular, the reinforcement be provided in both the directions like this, and both will be minimum reinforcement. So this is all about the design of circular tank for flexible base. So here I have summarized this. First of all, we calculate the design constants J K, R and M. Then we calculate the hoop tension gamma H into D by 2, which will be maximum at the base of your wall. Next we calculate the main reinforcement to the main reinforcement due to the hoop tension, which is AST is equal to T upon sigma ST. We assume the diameter of bar and calculate the spacing. Then we provide minimum reinforcement in vertical direction to support the hoops. Also, this reinforcement is usually provided in the center or near the bottom face, because the hoop tension is acting on the not the bottom face but the inner face of your tank wall, as the hoop tension is acting on the inner face. So we provide the reinforcement in vertical direction equal to minimum reinforcement, which is known as distribution steel. Then after finding the AST, we calculate the thickness of wall T upon 1000 T plus M minus 1 into AST less than sigma CT, where this is the permissible tensile stress. From this equation we calculate T and we choose a particular thickness of tank, and then we do the design of base slab in which we provide minimum thickness and minimum reinforcement in each direction. So this is the simple design procedure for your tank wall. This is as you can see here, this is the main vertical reinforcement, and the main reinforcement is hoop reinforcement provided in the form of hoops. So keep these points in mind. Whenever I'll be explaining you the next types of tanks, always remember in mind what is the main reinforcement, what is the distribution reinforcement, and how is the thickness of wall being calculated. As in each type of tank which we'll be discussing later on, these all will be different in different cases. So if you understand this the differences in each tank, you will not have any problem. So in circular tanks with flexible base, the main reinforcement is the horizontal reinforcement or the hoops which are provided along the height of wall, which are calculated on the basis of T. The vertical reinforcement is the distribution reinforcement, which is just the minimum reinforcement, AST minimum. Thickness of wall is calculated on the relation that the tensile stresses should be less than the permissible tensile stresses in concrete. Now we will be studying in the next topics that how main reinforcement is calculated, the distribution reinforcement is calculated, and how the thickness of wall is calculated. So always keep comparing these in your mind. So now we will do a design problem. So in this we have to design a circular tank with flexible base to carry water of capacity 450 kiloliters. The depth of water is given as 4.5 meter, and we have to use these grades of concrete and steel. So before designing, we need to we have been given the capacity of your tank, so we need to choose the dimensions of your tank. So the two main dimensions of your tank are its height and its diameter. So the height is given to us, that is 4.5 meter, and the diameter we will calculate like this. So the required capacity is 450 kiloliter, that is 450,000 liters. We will convert it to meter cube to get 450 meter cube. Now if we allow a freeboard of 200 mm, then effective depth of water will be 4.3 meter. So freeboard is the extra water level which we assume. So as you know, this is a kind of a cylindrical tank. So volume of a cylinder is pi by 4 d square into h. Here h is the height and d is the diameter. From this we can calculate the diameter of circular tank. So if the diameter of circle, and the required storage capacity is given, then you can calculate the diameter of tank in this way. Now we calculate the design constants of working stress method. So for these we require the permissible stresses. So we open our IS 3370 part 2 and look at this table, table number 1, 2 and 4. Table number 1 is for direct tensile forces. So permissible tensile forces in concrete for M30 is 1.5. From table number 2, the permissible bending stresses in concrete for M30 is 10. And from table number 4, the permissible tensile stresses in steel is 130 for HYST bars. We are taking here tensile stresses because we are calculating here the main reinforcements. So when we calculate sigma CBC, sigma CT and sigma ST, we calculate M, KJ and R and we get these final values which we will be using for further calculations. Now we calculate the hoop tension due to the water pressure, which will be gamma HD by 2, where gamma is the density of liquid. Here it is a water tank, so density is taken out to be 10. You can also take it to be 9.8. So we get the hoop tension to be 261 calculate. So the reinforcement which is required to carry this force will be AST required T upon sigma ST. If you note here, there is a big difference. Whenever we used to solve questions by limit state method, we always used to multiply the loads or the forces by a factor of 1.5 to get the design moments or forces. But we have not done here. We just used the value 261 here to calculate the reinforcement. This is because we are using working stress method, and in working stress method no such factors were allowed or were no provision was made for such factors. So we cannot use these. You should not use these. So AST required will be simply the force which is 261 upon 130 sigma ST, which we get as 2008 mm². Now we assume the diameter of bars and we calculate the spacing. You must be accustomed to this formula by now. So the calculated spacing is 156. So we provide a slightly lesser spacing. Hence provide 20 mm dia bars at 150 mm centipocenter in the bottom portion, and we can increase the spacing towards top because as the earth water pressure decreases as we move above, so the tension will also be less as we go towards top. Hence the required AST will be also less. So for economy point of view, we can increase the spacing in the upward direction. So if I make the elevation of your tank wall, the reinforcement will be closely spaced in the bottom portion, and it will be far. It will be having more spacing in the upper portion. So it will be something like this. Now we calculate thickness of the tank wall on the basis of the principle that the tensile stresses acting on the wall should be less than the permissible tensile stresses in concrete. So this is sigma CT, permissible tensile stress, which we get from table number 1. And tensile stresses will be the tensile force upon the equivalent area of concrete in the wall, which will be 1000 into T plus M minus 1 into AST provided. So AST provided is calculated here. So we have assumed the spacing to be 150 mm and diameter of bar 20. So we calculate the AST provided. The required spacing was 155 mm, but we provided 150 mm. So naturally AST provided will be more. So we put all these value in this equation and we get T, where M is the modular ratio, and we get the value of T. So this means that to satisfy this condition or this principle, the minimum thickness of tank wall should be greater than 157 mm. So I have taken it to be 200 mm with a cover of 30 mm. Now we calculate the vertical reinforcement. So the vertical reinforcement is required to support these hoops or rings. So there will be a vertical reinforcement required like this. So this is provided as the minimum area of surface zone, and the surface zone is taken just half of the area of the thickness of wall, because 200 mm is quite less thickness of wall, hence the surface zone will be on one side only. We need not provide reinforcement in the whole face of your wall. So provide 10 mm dia bars at 200 mm center to center. Now we design the base slab. For the design of base slab, we just assume the thickness of base slab. And the minimum thickness should be 150, so I have taken 200, and the minimum reinforcement is 350 mm square as calculated here. So we distribute this reinforcement in four directions. Four directions means, if this is a base slab, the total AST need to be provided like this, and the same will be done in the bottom face also. If you are providing reinforcement in one face only, that is on the top face or the bottom face only, then you will not divide this reinforcement by two. So you can take a 350 mm square. So it depends basically on the thickness of your base slab. In code it is written that for 200 mm thickness we do not require spacing, we do not require reinforcement on both faces, but for safety we provide reinforcement on both the faces of the base slab, just for safety and by considering the exposure condition or severe exposure condition on this particular slab. So this was the design of your circular tank with flexible base.